Hello, welcome back to the Cloud and Data Science channel. Hope you are all doing well. In today's video, we are going to see how to install the Docker engine and then how to deploy the Docker image and run that as a container to populate the Hello Docker message. In the last session, we have created virtual machine VM1 and we have seen how to connect that virtual machine VM1 using the user ID password authentication. So in this session to install the Docker image, we are going to use the same virtual machine. So let us launch our Cloud Shell. In the Cloud Shell, either we can use Bash or PowerShell. Now we are using the Bash Shell. So now let us connect to that virtual machine VM1. We can connect using the SSH command, SSH user ID. We have used in the last session Azure user 1. So we are going to use the same user ID, Azure user 1 address, IP address. That public IP address of that virtual machine is, this is the public IP address. So user ID, user at the rate IP. Now it is asking, are you sure you want to connect, continue? Yes. Then we need to enter the password for that virtual machine. Now we have entered the password and we are able to connect the virtual machine VM1. Okay. So now let us install the Docker. Basically to install the Docker, we need to install basic commands, DNF, and DNF plugins, okay? And then we will install the Docker from the Docker repository. So let us install the command dnf sudo m install dnf. Yes. Okay, now DNF command installation is completed. Now we are going to install the DNF plugins. These are required to install the Docker repository and then Docker engine. Okay, so now let us install the DNF config plugin command. So now we are installing the DNF plugins. Okay, now DNF plugins installation completed. Okay, now we will install the DNF config manager command. Okay. Now we are going to add the Docker repository using the DNF config manager. Okay. Let us add the Docker repository download.docker.com. That is the repo URL. Okay. So we have added the repo file. Okay, we have added the file repository URL. Okay, now let us install the Docker. Okay, now let us install the Docker. Okay, now we have added the DNF. We have added the now Docker repository. Okay, now we are going to install the Docker engine from this Docker repository. For that, we have to use sudo dnf install docker ce. Okay. Now we have installed the Docker engine. It is completed almost from the Docker repository. It is installing the, there are 9 components. So now it is installing the Docker engine. These are all the plugins as part of the Docker engine. Docker scan plugin, Docker CE, CLI, command line interface, container, Selinux, CLinux. Okay. Total 9 components. So we have installed almost all the 9 components. Okay, now Docker engine installation is completed. Now we are going to deploy the Docker image, Hello World image, as container on this Docker engine. Okay. Now let us enable this Docker service. Okay, now we have enabled the Docker. Okay, now let us change the permissions for that for user. Then only we will be able to. So our user is Azure user one, right? So we have to give permissions to the Azure user one to run the Docker. So we need to change the, modify the permissions. Okay, user is Azure user one. Okay, so we are giving the permissions Azure user one. Now we should log out and log back in so that the permissions will be enabled for this user to run the Docker image. Okay, to run that Docker image as container, okay, on the Docker engine. So let us log out this one and relaunch that one, Azure user. Okay, relaunch Cloud Shell. Now we relaunched the Azure. So let us connect to the Azure, our VM. We have connected to the Azure user one at the rate VM one. Okay. This is the our virtual machine and this is the user ID we have used. Okay. Now we have enabled the permission. Now we logged in back again to reflect the permissions for the that Azure user one to run the Docker container. Okay, so permissions are enabled on that virtual machine. Let us run the Docker container now. Docker run Docker IO hello world image, that is the Docker image which populates the message hello Docker. Okay, so now we are running the Docker image. This is the hello from Docker. So it downloaded the newer image from the Docker hub. See here, hello world latest status. It downloaded the newer image from the Docker hub. And this message shows that your installation appears to be working correctly. So we have installed the Docker engine and we pulled the Docker image, hello world image, and we are running that as a container on this Docker engine, which we already installed. So these are the steps. Basically, the Docker client connected to the Docker daemon, okay, and then the Docker daemon pulled the hello world image from the Docker hub. Then the Docker daemon created a new container from that image, which runs the executable that produces the output you are currently reading. The Docker daemon streamed that output to the Docker client, which sent to your terminal. Okay, so basically, the Docker process that is pulling the image and deploying that as a container, okay, on this Docker engine and sending back this message to the this terminal. Okay, now we can check the status of that system control status Docker. Okay, so it will show that this is active. So our Docker is active and it is running. So just to summarize, what we have done today is we have connected to our Azure virtual machine using the SSH user ID password authentication. Then we have installed the Docker engine using the repository, Docker repository. Okay, then after installing the Docker engine, we pulled the Docker image, hello world image, and deployed that as a container on the Docker engine. Okay, so that Docker container published the message hello Docker. Okay, that means our installation, Docker installation, is successful. Our Docker container is sample Docker container is successfully publishing the message hello Docker. So thanks for watching.